Hi, I'm Daniel. I graduated in 1996.
I'm Lauren. I'm a wannabe graduate in 99, graduated in 2000.
I'm Alicia Franks and I graduated in 99.
I'm Rebecca Stevenson and I graduated in 99.
I'm Josh Curtis. I graduated in 99.
I'm Asha Jocelyn and I graduated in 2011.
Where did we all end up?
So Dan, what do you want to be when you leave school, mate?
I'm going to play in the NBA, I think.
Oh, cool. That's awesome. Yeah. I can see you doing that.
What about you, Beck?
I want to be a famous actor and a famous singer.
Yeah, that's gonna happen. That's definitely gonna happen. Yeah, that's definitely gonna happen. That'd be unreal. I'd love that. I'll travel the world with you then. That's exactly what I want to do. I'm a boyfriend's everywhere. Yeah, travel the world. Yeah, make sure you stop and see me in Hollywood. I will. Yeah, I'm going to Hollywood, baby. Hollywood. Yep, my name in lights. Nice. Cool. Josh, what about you? Probably just, you know, be a musician or something. I don't know. I could sing.
What's what you're really good at? Oh, sorry.
You should pursue it, definitely. Yeah, I will.
Yeah.
What about you, Asha?
Yeah, Asha. I want to be a teacher. Probably back here.
Are you crazy?
Yes, it's a bit weird working with teachers who were once my teachers. Hi, Woodsy.
Hi.
Hi guys, I'm Alicia Franks and I'm the Indigenous Advisor here at Beerwah High. I've been working here for the last 7 years.
So what have I done since leaving Beerwah High? I ask myself that question all the time. It's been so long. Well, I never did manage to get all the boyfriends across the world, but I certainly have seen some amazing parts of the world, and I've travelled with some beautiful people and had some amazing experiences along the way, which I'm really fortunate for. Oh, and I met a great guy who takes me for who I am. We have the most beautiful looking children. Aren't they glamours? Look at them, little stunners. The motherhood takes up most of my time. Most of the time it feels like I'm rolling around with no direction, and it's bloody exhausting. In between that, I work with some amazing people at the local high school, which keeps me on my toes. But when I get home at night, I manage to do my best Jabba the Hutt impressions. Procrastinating. Well, I should be doing the final stages of my teaching degree. I'm rolling with the punches. And I wouldn't have it any other way.
So, Beck, what are you going to do when you leave school?
I don't know. Maybe I should become a teacher.
When we were in high school, the emphasis was not on alternative pathways and going to TAFE. We were really told to concentrate on getting a good OP and going to university.
And so
our Year 11s, these are the Eclectic Theatre Conventions.
Wow, Miss, that lesson was amazing. I want to be just like you.
I want to follow in your footsteps.
I idolise you.
You're fabulous, Miss.
This is for you. You're the best teacher in the world, Miss. Teach me how to be like you.
I adore you!
Hey, Miss, have you lost weight?
Yes. Yes, I think I will become a teacher. Okay, so perhaps teaching is not that glamorous, but I have to say I really do enjoy it. Back when I was a student, I loved drama as a subject and I loved being in the school musical, so naturally I became a drama teacher. When I was at school, my teachers were my greatest inspiration. I had some fantastic teachers and they are the reason why I'm doing what I'm doing today. And the best part is, those teachers have now become my colleagues and my really good friends. So I'm enjoying it.
Since leaving Beerwah, I went to QUT and studied a dual degree, a Bachelor of Fine Arts, majoring in Dance and Drama, and a Diploma of Education. And since finishing that, I'm back working at Beerwah. No, because I never worked at Beerwah before. So I'm not back working here. I'm back here working.
Doe, a deer, a female deer. Ray, a drop of golden sun. Me, a name I call myself. Far, a long, long way to run. So, a needle pulling thread. La, a note to follow. So, tea, a drink with jam and bread. That will bring us back to dough. Oh, oh, oh. Go!
Hi. I'm Josh Curtis and I graduated Beerwah State High School in 1999. I did have plans of going in and playing music and being some sort of successful musician and artist. And I mean, I've done a number of things where I've performed around Brisbane and the Sunshine Coast, originals, covers. I still love to write songs and record songs. However, it hasn't necessarily been the one thing that I find myself doing, not the main thing anyway. I do love doing it, however. I ended up completing a double degree in drama and education through QUT, and have since found myself at a number of different schools on the Sunshine Coast, and have recently in 2013 found myself back here at Beerwah State High School. So fun times. It's really cool actually being back and interacting with some of the old teachers that are still here, which is a testament to the school and you know, what it offered me as a young student. So outside of school and work and music, I found myself with three beautiful children, a daughter Isla who is 5, and twin boys who are 3 years old, Noah and Asher. So I think I found myself in a pretty lucky situation. Thanks.
My name is Stephen Berg. I graduated from Beerwah State High School in 2002. My favourite subjects were art, graphics, and computer studies. My least favourite subjects were math and physics, which is quite funny because I ended up becoming a computer programmer, which requires a lot of mathematics. I started programming at Beerwah State High School in my senior years. We would make small games using Visual Basic. Actually, my teacher for that was also my math teacher, Mr. Woods. After high school, I got a programming degree, and it took a while, but now I've gotten to work at a number of studios around Australia as both a games tester and a games programmer. Right now I'm working at Sponge Games on Fairly Breaks. Anyway, hard work pays off and dreams do come true. Remember that it doesn't matter how slow you're going, as long as you don't stop.
Hi, my name's Natalie Clossy. I graduated from Beerwah High in the year 2000. Since then, I've studied chiropractic and science. I graduated from Murdoch University in the year 2007. I was also awarded Australian Graduate of the Year across Australia. I now live in Brisbane with my husband and own my own chiropractic clinic. I'm currently studying a PhD at Central Queensland University. I have many fond memories of Beerwah High and the fabulous staff. Mr. Anderson and Mr. Jorgensen, Mrs. Hill were the principals when I was at high school, and all the wonderful couples, the Reeds, the Warworks, the Batemans, the Fenwicks. To all Beerwah High students and the new graduating class, I'm sure Beerwah High has prepared you well for the real world.
Hi, my name is Lisa Smith. I was part of the graduating class of 2003 at Beerwah State High School. I was school captain there, so I was kind of a big deal. Since I left high school, I went to the University of Queensland and I studied a business management degree majoring in marketing. I've since got a graduate position, follow shall we? I got a graduate position at News Corp doing advertising sales, and then I moved on to a Queensland marketing manager position with a health company. Just recently, the last couple of years, I have gone out on my own with my partner and I'm now self-employed, so we contract to that same company doing marketing and sales. So the benefit of being self-employed is that I can choose when I have time off. And in the last 13 years, I have spent all my free time and all my spare money on travel. So this is my 61st country that I've been to. I'm currently in Zimbabwe. And I'm doing a photography placement with an elephant and rhino conservation who are doing some really great work. So it's really exciting that I have the ability to follow some of my passions in my spare time. So I had some great teachers at school. Heidi Faulkner, Kath Bateman are two that probably stood out. They really gave me a lot of confidence in hindsight in myself, and also they helped me to push myself to do things and to put my hand up for things and say yes, and I think I do that a lot in my life now, so that probably stemmed from there, which is awesome. Throughout my travels, one thing that I've learned is that education unfortunately isn't a basic human right, it's a privilege, and the fact that you have that privilege, I think it's an opportunity to not to be wasted and something that you should grab hold of with both hands. The fact that you can get yourself educated and also pick what sort of industry you want to work in, I think is something that you should be really grateful for. So stay in school, kids, and have fun. Bye.
Hi, I'm Kate Wilson, and while I graduated from Beerwah High in 2001, my memories of the school actually go back further than that. My dad, Peter Wilson, was one of the first people to be employed at Beerwah High. And I spent most of 1992 running around the port racks playing hide and seek with my little sister. During my own high school years, I got involved in just about every extracurricular activity going. I was a Tumbabudla house captain in 2001, and I also started a school newspaper called Off the Record. After school, I became a journalist and I worked for newspapers on the Sunshine Coast and in Bundaberg. I covered a lot of politics and got to interview John Howard, Kevin Rudd, and Julia Gillard. After a while, I got lured into politics and eventually found myself running social media for the Premier of Queensland. Being Campbell Newman on social media was a pretty interesting job. I learned a whole bunch of new insults and occasionally got to do some cool stuff, like go to the G20 meeting when it was in Brisbane. Nowadays, I'm running my own business in Brisbane and I still get to play hide and seek, but it's with my little nephews and my niece.
Hi everyone, I'm Jessica Kidd. Though at school I was Jessica Goodread. I graduated in the year 2000 and I was also the school captain. Since finishing school, I've travelled around the world and 11 years ago settled in Sydney. I'm married, I've got a 14-month-old daughter. I work in financial services and I also teach group fitness, mixed martial arts and weights. Even though I grew up in a small country town called Peachester that nobody in Sydney has ever heard of, it just goes to show that doesn't matter. If you've got a good education, you can do whatever you want to do and live wherever you want to live. Congratulations, Beerwah, on turning 25. Good luck to all of those graduating this year, and hopefully I can get back up there soon and show my daughter the beautiful place that I grew up with.
Hi guys, I'm Eliza Orenshaw, formerly Eliza King. I graduated from Beerwah High in 2003. I'm now a high school teacher. I teach English and Humanities from grade 6 to 12. I married my best friend and had two beautiful children. We're no longer married, but we are still best friends. Just wanted to let you guys know that Beerwah High is an amazing school. It supported me and helped me decide what I wanted to be was a teacher. That's because the teachers there inspired me and I wanted to help students the way that they helped me. Two of the teachers that I had are still there now, Mrs. Brewer and Mrs. Bateman, so you guys should count yourselves lucky. All right, good luck with everything. Bye.
Hi, my name's Crystal Winkler. I graduated from Beerwah State High in the year 2000. After high school, I went on to study a Bachelor of Law at Queensland University of Technology. I graduated from my degree in the year 2006 and went on to become a lawyer. And I now work at a medium-sized firm on the outskirts of the city. And I specialise in corporate law, property law, not-for-profit law, helping lots of charities, and also a bit of elder law, helping old people as well with their various needs. In 2003, I was married, and my husband and I have four little girls aged 8, 5, 2, and 6 months old, so life is very busy for us. I always think back at Beerwah State, of my days at Beerwah State High with a smile. I remember all of the teachers that I had, and I value their input into my life. So do value your teachers while you're there. Enjoy your 9 to 3 days because they don't last for long and life gets very busy. I do remember many funny incidences, Mr. Turner's fluffy pink pencil case, Mr. Foreman's funny stories from his days in the electricity field. I remember Mr. and Mrs. Bateman, Mrs. Proben, and her Bold and the Beautiful episodes that we watched. I hope you all have a great night tonight, and goodbye.
Hi, my name is Tiffany. I graduated from Beerwah State High in 2001. I was pretty lucky in high school. I had a pretty solid sense of direction. I knew what I was going to do when I graduated, and that's because ever since I was a little girl, I always wanted to pursue a career in hairdressing. So when I graduated, I won a scholarship at Winholshire Academy in Brisbane, which is where I gained my Certificate 3. With that, I worked in a number of different salons throughout Brisbane and on the Sunshine Coast. I worked over in London for a little while as well, and over the years gradually worked my way up into 2IC and management positions, which was really lots of fun. I did that right up until I fell pregnant with my first child. I have a little girl who is aged 4 and I have twin boys who are aged 3. So they've kept me on my toes for the last few years where I've just been full-time mumming. And in that time, I sort of decided that hairdressing had kind of lost its luster for me. So I decided to do something entirely different this year. I am now a full-time student at the University of the Sunshine Coast where I'm studying a Bachelor of Business. I am absolutely loving it. It's really great. I never thought I would go to university, but here I am. I guess in my experience, I went into high school sort of thinking I wanted to be a hairdresser and that was it. So I didn't think I really needed to graduate. I didn't think I really needed an OP score. So in hindsight though, I'm pretty glad that I did do those things because they gave me the credit I needed to be doing what I'm doing today. I guess my advice to up-and-coming graduates would be if you don't know what it is that you want to do before you graduate, don't worry about that. There's a number of opportunities available to you out there and you don't even know half of them yet. So it is actually worth the time. Finding out what it is that you are passionate about, something that you might enjoy, inspires you. So if you find something that does that for you, that is probably the thing that you'll be most successful at. I guess that's probably all from me. Happy 25 years, Beerwah State High, and thanks for my secondary education.
Hi all, my name's Matt Faso and I am a student from the graduating class of 2001 from Beerwah High School. I had a really good experience during my time at Beerwah and had the very fortunate opportunity to be taught by and mentored by a range of very inspiring staff, so much so that I continued my educational journey outside of school and became a teacher myself outside when I completed my university studies. And this led to a number of further opportunities to teach in London for a couple of years and also an opportunity in Singapore. And I now find myself as a guidance officer in a high school in Bundaberg. The one thing I really wanted to emphasise in this video that was the most meaningful experience for me at school was the opportunity to be involved in the numerous cultural, arts and musical endeavours and programs that run within the school. Being musical, that was a really important part of my schooling, and having taught in a range of different schools now, it's something that I know now really sets Beerwah apart and set Beerwah apart when I was there, the way that they celebrate individuality and give everyone an opportunity to succeed in whatever field it may be that they prefer or that they're talented in. So this really helped me to continue on with music and to pursue it further. I was a professional musician and worked for singing and playing guitar for a living once I left school and worked my way through university doing that and continue doing that now in the wedding industry, which has now led me, and I've been fortunate enough to win the Best Live Musician in Queensland at the Australian Bridal Industry Awards for the past 2 years. So I'm confident that none of these opportunities that I've, or none of these achievements that I've had in my life to this point would have been possible if it wasn't for just that bit of mentorship and guidance from the staff I had at Beerwah. So congratulations to Beerwah on your anniversary, and I hope to make it down there and catch up with everyone on the day. Thanks very much.
Hi, my name's Samantha Tonisu. I graduated from Beerwah High School in 2001. I actually met my husband at Beerwah High School in year 8. We now have 2 children that are 9 and 10 years old. When I left Beerwah High School, I took a year off to travel for a year up north, went to Ellie Beach, did some dive courses around there. I came back to start a Bachelor of Science the following year. I actually fell pregnant at the end of my 3rd year with my daughter, so I didn't end up doing honours in my 4th year as I had planned. We then went on to have another child, a boy, the following year. I tried to go back to do my honours when my daughter was 6 months old, but it wasn't going to happen, so scrapped that idea. My husband, Aaron Tonisu, joined the Defence Force, so we then moved to Victoria and lived there for 3 years. The kids were 1 and 2 when we moved down there. And we then lived in Darwin for 3 years, and there are some amazing places in Darwin. So if you can get a chance to get out and see Australia, I'd highly recommend it. So my career really started 5 years after I had the kids. I went back and did a Masters of Environmental Management, and I started my career working with Northern Territory Fisheries and a consultancy called Cardno. I then, we moved back to Brisbane then. Aaron got a posting back to Brisbane, and I worked with Fisheries in Queensland for a year, and I'm currently working with Fisheries in Nambour with the impact assessment and management team. So I actually took a pay cut and dropped to an admin role to get into this location. But now I am a fisheries biologist there, really loving the work. Great location, great team that I work with. So set your goals, work hard, and you've got all the teachers that you need at Beerwah High to give you great support. And good luck to you all.
Hi, I'm Tennille Card. I was at Beerwah from 2003 to 2010. I was lucky enough to be Mickey T. Bumblegry's head of house and teach English, humanities and health. I'm now at Burnside State High School. I'm head of year 12 and I'm teaching English.
Hi, my name's Megan Piper. I used to work at Beerwah. I started there in 2002 and I was there for 4 years. I was a dance teacher and I also met my current husband, Cameron Piper there, who was a HPE teacher. So Beerwah has many fond memories for me.
Hello, my name's Mark Page. I was a student at Beerwah High from 2000 to 2005. One of my best memories from attending school at Beerwah was house captaining Nigun Gun to their first athletics carnival win. Currently, I'm a teacher now at Burnside State High School, and that's due partly to my great time as a student at Beerwah High.
Hi, I'm Kerry Dunn. I was deputy principal at Beerwah High School from 2000 to 2005, and now I'm the principal of Burnside High School. Have a great anniversary.
Hi, I'm Jo Byrne, and I was at Beerwah High. I've come from the dance floor at Beerwah High and Year 12 coordinator. I'm now working at Burnside High School as head of international and languages. Having a great day at the celebrations. Thank you.
Hi, my name's Hayley Bree. I graduated from Beerwah High School in 2001. I have many fond memories of Beerwah High, school captain in 2001, which I loved, and had many wonderful teachers that I put on a pedestal and were mentors for me in school, and I thought about them when I left quite often as well. I went straight into university after Beerwah and I went to QUT and did a business degree in PR and advertising. I worked in the event management industry for quite a little while and then I got the teaching bug and decided to go back to university, which was only a few years ago. I became a high school teacher and I had one of my first contracts at Beerwah High School, which was quite exciting and a little bit surreal going back and teaching with some of the teachers who had taught me back in my high school days. I'm now a permanent teacher at Burnside High School in Nambour and absolutely love teaching here, and one of my most favourite things about teaching at Burnside is I get to teach with some of my teachers that I had when I was at Beerwah High. Kerry Dunn, she was my deputy principal, now she's my principal and boss here at Burnside High. Kimberly Cooch, Jo Byrne, some wonderful teachers who I'm really happy to come to school and see every day. They were my mentors in high school and they're also my mentors now as a young teacher myself. So happy 25th anniversary, and I hope everyone has a lot of fun, and I have such wonderful memories of Beerwah High School.
Hi, my name's Kimberly Cooch. I was a teacher at Beerwah High from 1996 to 2006, so 10 years there. I taught a lot of subjects, but mainly in the business faculty, accounting, legal studies, and ICT. One of my fondest memories of being at Beerwah High was being the Year 12 coordinator, where I got to plan the Grade 12 graduation ball, so that was lots of fun, lots of work, but lots of fun. And I wish you a happy 25th anniversary.
Hi, my name is Tara Towns and I was in the graduating class of 2000. When I was in grade 8, it was the first time the school had a full 5 grades, grade 8 to grade 12. So I witnessed the first graduating class ever from Beerwah State High School. The high school itself was an incredible experience and I loved my time at Beerwah. The thing that made it the most memorable were probably the experiences and the teachers. I was privileged to have a multitude of experiences at Beerwah, from being part of the band to being in musicals and drama productions, doing debating, public speaking, being involved in sport with volleyball and tennis, and just the amount of experiences that the school offered left me with a lifetime of memories. The other thing that I think made Beerwah so special was its teachers. So I had teachers who have been with me in my, I suppose, adventure to become a teacher myself. They were an inspiration to me, particularly Mrs. Holland, who showed me great empathy and support and understanding through my journey all through high school as a drama teacher. Miss Bateman and Miss Boosten, who supported me through debating and rostrum and public speaking, not to mention in the English classroom. Miss Thompson, who was an endless support through my BCT in grade 11 and 12, and Mrs. Cameron, who was my film and television teacher. But more than that, these incredible ladies were inspirational teachers and human beings, and it is probably the reason that I am a high school teacher myself today, and I try to channel these amazing teachers in my practices as well. So thank you, Beerwah, for giving me the opportunities that you did, and best of luck for all the rest of the high school graduation class for this year. Thanks.
Hello, Beerwah State High School. My name is Jasmine Michaels, formerly Jasmine Williamson, and I am class of 2003. So, brief rundown. After I finished school, I went and lived in North America for 12 months. I was at the Canadian ski fields for 6 months and in New York for another six. When I got home, I studied four different degrees before settling on a Bachelor of Communications. And I'm now the Media and Communications Manager for QSNTS, which is Australia's largest native title law firm. And I'm also now finishing my second degree, which is a Bachelor of Laws. What else? I'm married to my partner, Luke, and I'm also a stepmom to Hannah, who is six, and I'm currently 31 weeks pregnant due Christmas Day. Fun. I have a lot of fond memories of Beerwah State High School. My legal studies teacher, Ms. Cooch, she used to threaten me with detention because I never took my textbook to class, but I think she'd probably be proud of me now because I'm actually doing pretty good in the Bachelor of Laws. Ms. Bateman was my debating coach. I used to leave all of my speeches to the last minute, and that hasn't really changed, so that's a personality flaw. Miss Brewer was my English teacher, and she was wonderful as well, and there are so many others, just way too many to name. So advice for current students, I think I will just say that your life plan is going to look completely different in about 5 years' time, so don't feel like you have to have it all figured out just yet. My life didn't really come together until I was about 26, and I'm only 30 now, so late bloomer. Anyway, I think that's it from me, but happy birthday, Beerwah State High School, and goodbye.
Hello, Colin Gavigan here from the graduating class of 2002. This is just a quick Where Are They Now video. I've been pestered enough times to finally get my ass into gear and to do this. I'm currently in the middle of data processing for my current study. Since leaving Beerwah State High School, after a couple of years of fumbling, I found my way into academics, and particularly I'm doing sport exercise science. So I did a bachelor's of sport exercise science at the University of Sunshine Coast, and I went on to do a honours in biomechanics, and I'm currently doing a PhD in biomechanics and skill acquisition. My focus is on martial arts research, primarily because it's really interesting to me and it's a lot of fun. So what you can see here is I'm actually using a program which is very similar to the programs they use for cinematography and computer game production. It's their 3D motion capture. So the research I'm doing is looking at how adaptive movement can be and how variable it can be depending on the situation you're in. So it's one of the first of its kind in the world, so that's kind of cool. I've also recently married. a beautiful woman that I met in the States. Her name's Elaine. She's holding the camera right now. And we're expecting a baby in April 22nd, yeah. So that's where I am right now. Hope this meets the criteria. Everybody, best of wishes. And again, happy 25th celebration. Bye.
Hi there, my name's Vic Sabo. I was a graduate of Beerwah High School in the year 2002. I've been up to a lot since I finished high school in 2002. It seems like an age ago. But one of my main achievements was that I completed a degree in naturopathy at Southern Cross University, and I'm still in northern New South Wales. I've come a bit of a distance, but currently I'm working at Southern Cross University in a plant science lab. So it keeps me busy. It's quite a good job. So that I got that as a result of doing my degree there. I also own two beautiful ex-racing greyhounds, which are a bit of, you know, the two loves of my life. They're so gorgeous. Here they are. Snooky girl, and Milo. They're ex-racers, so we're pretty lucky to have them, and, you know, they're beautiful kids. I don't have kids, by the way. These are my kids. So a few things. So I've got a few fond memories of Beerwah High School. For instance, one of them was when I was in grade 9, I got the highest achiever award in the Shop A, which was, I think, Woodwork. I think it was Shop A. And I beat all the boys, so that was like, woo, I beat all the boys. That was funny. That was a particularly fond memory. And I had some really great teachers, like there was Mrs. Bateman, Mr. Bateman, Mrs. Zirikowski, maths, yeah. So I had some really good teachers, I remember, like just really lovely people and really supportive and encouraging and stuff. I also loved being in the Tournament of Minds a few times, I think. That was fun. I was in the musical in 2002. I think it was called Deluge, and I was the hippie auntie, Mrs. Auntie Jess or something. So that was fun, just singing and performing and stuff. Yeah, and if I had a message for current students, it would probably be something like, don't stress about what you want to do, like if you don't know what you want to do, because I still don't know what I want to do, really. But you get there, as long as you keep yourself busy and occupied and, you know, plodding along, you'll find something eventually that fits your life and what you want to do. And also, because, you know, I had some health problems when I was in high school, and I had quite a lot of time off and things, and it was all a bit of a roller coaster. But I remember that Beerwah High School, they were really supportive. So I had really good teachers, and I was able to actually come back and finish grade 12 when I was a bit older, and that was really, really good that I was able to do that. So just keep going, and, you know, you can achieve so much, like even if you've got all sorts of issues and stuff, you might think it's, you know, the end of the world and you're doomed or whatever, but you're not. Like, time goes and, you know, life gets better, and life is good. Thanks, everyone. It's, wish I could be there.